I would invite Dr. Anita Jagetia. She's a professor at GB Pant Hospital in New Delhi, India. Madam would be talking on utility of intravesical injections in lumbar spine surgery. Dr. Anita.
Good afternoon, all. I'm talking about utility of intradiscal injection in lumbar disc disease. Good afternoon, all. I'm talking about utility of intradiscal injection in lumbar disc disease. It's not moving. Yeah. The indications for intradiscal injections are diagnostic and therapeutic. Diagnostic for discography is now nowadays almost obsolete. However, it is very routinely used for almost all minimally invasive surgeries for the disc disease. So nucleolysis, chemonucleolysis, laser, nucleoplasty, or discoidectomy. So we analyzed our data of grade 1 and grade 2 lumbar or lumbar sacral disc diseases for grade 1 and grade 2 only, and who did not have any neurological deficit and only local pain or the radiating pain without any sensory motor deficit. And methylene blue injection was made before minimally invasive discography in patients with grade 3 and grade 4 lumbar disc. So one need to understand clearly the anatomical landmark of this lumbosacral area for the ozone, for the needle placement device. So this is a setup of the OT. Patient is placed in the spinal attachment prone position, and the C-arm is placed on the side of the operator. On the side, like if the operator is standing and doing on the right side, injecting from the right side, and then the C-arm has to be on the right side, and the monitor is placed opposite to the C-arm, which is that is facing the operator. And this is ozone making machine, and which requires the cylinder, oxygen cylinder. Now two needles are used to go into the disc. One is 18 gauge, the bigger needle, the bigger in the outer needle, and through this the smaller gauge, that is 22 gauge, but 15 centimeter needle is taken inside the disc or inserted in the disc under the fluoroscopic guidance. Ozone is prepared using a ozone generator machine and the oxygen cylinder. And 6 to 8 cc of the ozone oxygen mixture can be injected into the disc. And when we are injecting the methylene blue, 1 ml of methylene blue and 1 ml of iohexol is taken to make the solution of the powder of methylene blue. So how this ozone acts? Ozone is converted into its free radical singlet oxygen, which attaches to the proteoglycan bridges and breaks the bridges. And this, once they are broken, the proteoglycan is not able to hold the water anymore, and this will lead to shrinkage of the disc. So in the lateral view, we just confirm the level L3, L4, L4, L5, this level. And after confirming in the lateral view, we just make the C-arm in the oblique position, and it is angulated in such a way that the facet joint should come in the middle of the body, and when it comes in the middle of the body, one can see the Scotty dog appearance. This is Scotty dog appearance. This is the nose, which corresponds to the transverse process, pedicli, ear, the superior articular process, front leg, the inferior articular process, and neck is the pars intraarticularis. When one is choosing the L5-H1 as the level to put the needle, we need to understand the Kamen's triangle. Here is the facet joint, this is the end plate, and one can see the shadow. This shadow is the iliac crest. So this area is Kamen triangle, and this is very small area, and this comes around 8 to 10 centimeters from the midline, depending upon the posture, the anatomy of the patient. So this is, one can see the needle here in the Kamen's triangle. This is like crest, facet joint and end plate. And this is, we need to identify this area. So angulation is made in such a way that both the craniocaudal, the oblique is made in such a way that one gets this in the middle of the facet joint in the middle, the Scotty dog appearance, and the iliac crest from here makes the lateral bond. So after inserting the needle, one need to confirm the needle position. It should be towards the midline, that it is the intraspinal, because the needles are inserted off the midline around 4-5 centimeters or 8 to 10 centimeters. So one need to confirm that we are in the towards the midline, not paramedian. And in the lateral position, the needle should be at least in the middle of the disc. After confirming, one can inject 4 to 6 ml of ozone inside the disc, and while coming out from the disc, one can inject the facet joint and the muscle vein as well. This is the injection of the methylene blue, which is hypodense, and this is made by using the iohexol, so that we can see where all the injection is going. So none of the patient of ozone required open surgery. However, 6 cases required repeat injection in the follow, and one patient had numbness which improved gradually over 6 weeks. Intraoperative injection of methylene 2 helped in easy identification of the disc. So these are representative cases of ozone, grade 1, little disc, but of course severe pain, and after 3 months, nice, good result. This is grade 2 disc herniation in a patient, and in the follow-up, both nerve roots are fine and free from the compression. This is intraoperative picture of the methylene blue injected in the disc, and we can clearly differentiate this disc from the nerve root, and this is the colored disc material. So the patients who were subjected for ozone nucleolysis, there was very gross reduction in VAS score, very significant, from 8 to 3 at 3 months follow up, and the statistically significant reduction in the ODI also in the follow up. So to conclude, intradiscal ozone injections can provide long term pain relief in select cases. Dye injections can help in identification of the disc, and that can prevent injury to the nerve roots in minimally invasive surgery. However, knowledge of radiological anatomy and landmarks is very essential for disc space injections. Thank you for patience. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for that timely presentation. I am sure this is one topic which is very interesting, and we can discuss a lot about it.